intellectual pack. Assemble. It is time for another episode of BCW Warzone. I am yours truly, Jacob Blaze, and I am your sole commentator for BCW. Excuse me. And opening the night tonight, we have Killie going up against Jezebel. Oh! And the ref gets taken down. Dropkick from Killie. And a kick to the inside of the leg. And another one. And a third. Back and forth. And tries for a half and half, but oh! What a boot from Jezebel. Saito suplex. Another drop kick. Hits her in the head. Just beating her down. Is Killie. Face washing her. And another Saito suplex. And now going for the pin. And only a one count. Easy kick out from Killie. Stunner on the outside. Slides back inside the ring, does Killie. What a kick to the head from Killie, or I mean to her. Oh, fall from heaven! One, two. Snapmare. has her on the outside. Sends her into the barricade. And a kabat suplex. Ref up to a count of four, five now. Sends her into the apron. And sends her back inside the ring. I think Kitty Gay might have been looking for the sharpshooter. And a cravat again. This time on the inside of the ring. Next up, we have Gabriel Slade going up against Mike Savage. Now, Gabriel Slade has been a bit up and down on the winning and losses, or the wins and losses here in BCW. He's got to come out on top with a win here tonight because, honestly, he is really starting to doubt himself lately. In fact, here my notes, it says, like, apparently, actually, no, it says that Gabriel Slade was quoted saying backstage, as a recent on social media, saying, I'm kind of considering retiring because I don't know if I still have it. I don't know if I can still go in that ring. I have lost so many matches. And had so little wins as of late. I kind of wonder, do I have it or not? Because I don't know what to do in my career if I don't. So Gabriel Slade. He wants to get back in that winning column. I mean, a lot of our superstars here in BCW want the same thing, and honestly, with working hard and all that, you know, you kind of gotta wonder what he's gotta do to do it, what he has to do, what he has to pull out of the bag to win here tonight against Mike Savage.
And his opponent from Columbus, Ohio, weighing in at 220 pounds, Gabriel Slade.
Gabriel Slade.
Oh, God!
making his way to the ring. It seems like the old Gabriel Slay we're looking at here, but I don't know. Here we go. Oh! I don't know what Slade was looking for to do there, but he went the exact wrong way. Oh, trying to bury the boots into the chest of Mike Savage. That is some aggression from Gabriel Slade, and a huge back kick. Oh! Wicked clothesline to Mike Savage. And again, Savage. Savage throws him inside the ring. savagery. No. Say, I think we found our newfound aggression from Gabriel Slade with the win here tonight. But next up, and you may wonder why I'm picking Chase to play as well. I got a bit of a storyline planned. Of course, this is JC defending the BCW Extreme Impact Championship against, representing the order, Chase. Now the order had one hell of a vendetta against the family.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the ECW Extreme Impact Championship.
Ryan Rage. Who currently put their leader, that being the Order's leader, out on injury with a severe concussion and a hairline neck fracture. Now we do have a bit of an update on Jacob Cass. He said, and I quote, "I am on my way to recovery, and currently, doctors said I am not quite ready to get in the training to a, for a return." But... the surgery went well, and I will be back in that BCW ring sooner than you think. I mean, honestly, how true that is, how, you know, much, you know, we can plan to see anything like that happen anytime soon is as yet unknown. However, I do think that, you know, maybe we can guarantee a possible return for Jacob Cass as soon as BCW Rumble in the Bronx.
Introducing the challenger from Memphis, Tennessee, weighing in at 195 pounds, Chase! And his...
Here we go. Oh! What the heck was that? And Chase taking it to the Extreme Impact Champion. Not forget that his father, that being JC's father, has a history of knee injuries. But I don't think Chase is worried about the knee injuries. He's trying to give JC a concussion, like his leader. .450 to the outside. Yeah. Oh my god. What? Ladies and gentlemen. Chase does it. I cannot believe what we just saw. But ladies and gentlemen, next up, we have the hardcore champion, Anthony Davidson, going one-on-one with Bad Bunny. This should be one heck of a match, that's for sure. Anthony Davidson in his first championship opportunity against Phoenix Nitro. Davidson. Defeated. Phoenix Nitro for that hardcore championship. Which looked a little different then. Back inside the ring. And Bad Bunny. Oh my god! barricade. Easy kick out. From Bad Bunny. Has him up. Thunder Cutter! And Bad Bunny about to be thunderstruck! One, two! Excuse me, what? Says you want to get up? Get up again. I'm drag. And another kick out from Anthony. Off the ropes. Bad Bunny turns it around on him. Has him up. Thunder Cutter! And now once again, Thunderstruck! I don't think he thinks that's enough. Thunderstruck again! Those are the pain again. Thank you. Does he want to rope break me? Next up, we got the Savior, Pierce Perch, the BCW United States Champion, going up against Tommy Brooks. If Tommy Brooks can somehow ink out a win here tonight against Pierce.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring from Topeka, Kansas, weighing in at 268 pounds, the Outlaw, Tommy Brooks!
Yeah! That's right!
I gotta make a change for one of the matches though tonight. Some does Pierce. And a Saito suplex. Our Tommy Brooks with a combo. Back and forth. Oh, wait. Kick out from Pierce. Star press from Pierce. Sends him right into the barricade. Nice combination there. Inside the ring. Oh, but he got caught. Planted. One, two, no. Oh, wait a minute. Tommy Brooks. taking Pierce on a trip to the south. Now Tommy Brooks. Next up, we have Chris Danger going up against the undefeated Black Heron. He is not only undefeated, though, he is also the undefeated BCW World Heavyweight Champion, Black Heron.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing in at 163 pounds, Chris Danger. Champion, B.H.
Here we go. A wicked clothesline from here, and in danger. Already in a bad way here. Black Aaron might just do that. Clothesline from Black Heron. Nice combination there. And then hits it again. Again, a kick out. Oh! Dark matter again! no. I think Black Hair might be looking for Final Flight. Through the table. But wait. What?
Here is your winner, Chris. Danger!
Since his debut, Black Heron has not been defeated once. And here tonight, Black Heron has been pinned by Chris Danger. Ladies and gentlemen, we have witnessed history. But next up, is Jeremy Davidson versus Jack Barber.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the family from Champlin, Minnesota,
yeah,
weighing in at 265 pounds, Jeremy Davidson.
Yeah.
I keep forgetting to turn off his music. Here we go. Jack Barber really having it taken to him here. And now being curled by Jeremy Davidson, and now a fallaway slam. Drags him away from the ropes. Oh, wait! The Demon's Curse! You've not seen this in a long time. At least not from Jeremy Davidson. Headbutt to the shoulder. Springboard forearm. Best elbow in the world, connecting, but unable to get the three count. Jeremy Davidson has had enough. Oh, no, he hasn't. Drew him in. I'm not really sure what that was. Barber just got launched, and now pedigree. And now going up top. Frog splash to the back. And now going up top again here. Locked in. again, another backbreaker. Demon's curse. Military pressing him. Make him submit. Demon's curse locked in. But again, Jack Barber able to get out of it.
Here is your winner, Jack Barber.
That was a bit controversial, I would say. But next up, we have Rachel Rose going up against Jesse, or the Phantom, Jesse Davidson. This is our post main event.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making her way to the ring from the Queen City, the Queen, Rose Rachel Rose. Representing Le Femme Fatales from Fargo, North Dakota, the ECW Women's World Champion, the Phantom Jesse Davidson.
BCW Women's World Heavyweight Champion. The Phantom Jesse Davidson. Women trying to go for big moves to start, but oh, women missing it. And back and forth. Big DDT. Nice neck breaker there. Yeah. Another big elbow drop. DDT there from Jesse. Now gonna wear out the arm of Rachel Rose to set her up for that. Phantom lock, no doubt. And next up in our main event, we have Hector Flores going one-on-one with the most dangerous man. In all of professional wrestling, Ryan Rage Won't deny it. I'm a straight rider. Whoops. Not mean to play that, guys. I was trying to add that to my other playlist.
The following contest is a steel cage match. Making his way to the ring, representing The Order, from Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, weighing in at 202 pounds, Flores.
Wait, what? What? Oh my God. Ladies and gentlemen, there was an altercation backstage moments ago. In fact, before the match with Jesse happened, that was Chase.
And his Hector opponent Flores, from Asheville, North Carolina.
Paragon J. Pierce.
Pounds,
as well.
Junior Heavyweight Assault Champion, Ryan Drake.
J.C. Davidson. Backstage. And what I'm hearing from the doctors right now is that JC has come down with an injury. And it is confirmed that it is a torn pectoral muscle. And unfortunately, that means he has unfortunately has to relinquish the BCW Internet Championship. Having it taken to him by Hector Flores here. But I think that is it. I have a feeling that Ryan Rage heard that announcement by me moments ago. And he wants to take it out on Hector Flores here. Spanish fly. Mosh Pit Murder. Easy kick out. Very special. I don't think he's done. Forearm! Mosh Pit Murder!
Here is your winner, Ryan Rage.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is going to do it for this episode of BCW Warzone. I will see you guys again tomorrow for another episode of Mass Effect 2, as well as another episode of Far Cry 6. As always, though, remember, Stay safe. Stay dangerous. Love you guys. Later.